Violence has broken out in parts of Niger following the announcement of the presidential election results. Ruling party candidate Mohamed Bazoum was declared the winner, but the opposition has also claimed victory. It's rejecting the results, insisting that the vote was rigged. Let's discuss the situation in that country now with David Zoumanou, a senior research consultant with the Institute for Security Studies. A very good morning to you. Tell us more about how this is playing out and how dangerous it is potentially.
Good morning to you and good morning to the viewers. Look, the situation is dangerous because of the context, a particular context in which Niger found itself. Ideally, this election was supposed to help Niger taking a bold step in achieving the very first peaceful democratic transition from transfer of power from one elected president to the other. This has never happened in the country before because other transfer of power have been interrupted by a military coup. And for the past 10 years, Niger has known too. Also, Niger is facing growing insecurity, both from the eastern region or from the western region, with Al-Qaeda affiliated group. So any political instability will simply put the country in difficulty and create the chaos. But I believe that the government is now trying to respond, and the opposition party has said they will resort to legal means to challenge the result, which is already a good sign.
Yeah, and I suppose this is inevitable when it is a country that is used to coups and sort of some sort of military intervention, that it's not just going to be such an easy transition as we'd all like to see.
Definitely, I think that's the state for both candidates. Mahamat Usman has been the first democratically elected president in 1993. So for him, this is a time to seek revenge, political revenge, of course, by rehabilitating himself because his rule has been interrupted in 1996 by the military coup led by Ibrahim Barre Maina Sara, who was also killed later in 1999 in the bloodiest coup that Niger has a scene. So the challenge for both candidates, particularly for Mohamed Bazoum, who has been fighting for democracy, democratic consolidation in his country for the past three decades, is simply to make sure that the military remain out of the politics and the debate remain in the hand of a citizen where legitimacy can come from.
Okay, and we're all hoping that democracy will flourish there. What sort of impact is that likely to have on the country, its economy, human rights abuses?
It's very important, that question, because, you know, Niger has been among the poorest countries in the world, sitting right at 189 at the bottom of the various agency classification. So it's remained a challenge for whoever is going to be elected to develop coherent and effective strategies to address security, to address education, to address the poverty. I think 44% of Nigerian citizens are affected by poverty, and particularly how to really streamline the country's development. The country has experienced at least five rebellions in the past, and we hope the political stability is not. It will be possible for the country to resort to democratic means to resolve a conflict. But also in West Africa, where leaders are amending the constitution opportunistically to remain in power, Niger is sending a very strong signal that two mandates.
I was going to ask you about that, the wider ramifications and what sort of impact it's likely to have on its neighbors and what they're thinking looking in.
I think it keeps the hope for democracy alive in West Africa, because the region has not been well off lately with what is happening, what has happened in Guinea, what has happened in Cote d'Ivoire, what is likely to happen in Chad and elsewhere. It seems like a democratic space is shrinking. Leaders are creative or trying to create a mechanism to change the constitution or their birth certificate to remain at the helm of power for forever, which affects both security and development in their respective countries.
Well, we wish them well. Important for Niger, important for the continent. David, thanks for talking to us.